Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another bite-sized speed build. Now, as you can tell from the title of today's video, we are designing a modern dive bar today. And if you guys have stuck around for the concrete jungle house design, this is definitely another play on words. Now, I really don't know too much about dive bars in real life, but I did play them in The Sims 3, so yeah, I think that's my only true basis for what a dive bar truly is. But from what I understand, I think a dive bar is supposed to be sort of a more affordable bar, something that's maybe not too extravagant, something that's kind of like your local watering hole, if you will. But obviously today's video is going to be a really big twist on that. So I was really trying to think of something interesting to build, especially for some kind of nightclub venue lot. And I thought of the dive bar itself. Now, in The Sims 4, unfortunately, we don't have the luxury of having all of the different venue types in The Sims 3. So I think in The Sims 3, we had a poolside club, we had a plasma lounge, we had a fusion lounge, which I don't really know what that was. But honestly, there was just such a great variety. But with The Sims 4 get together, I do believe the only lot types we get are a nightclub and also a cafe. So kind of inspired by the dive bar and also the poolside club from The Sims 4, I wanted to create a literal dive bar. So this is definitely going to be a little bit more on the sleek, modern, luxurious side. This is not some kind of, some kind of dingy joint on the side of the street, but something that actually will fit the world of Windenburg. And if you guys have been in this area, it's quite nice. This is more of the modern contemporary district. And the lot that was here, I believe, was also water themed. So I do think it was either themed around the ocean or the pool itself. So I thought, you know what, this is a really great place to put this lot down. Anyways, playing off that dive bar aspect, we will have a poolside area, which you can kind of see shaping up on the side. And the building itself was in the shape of a wave. So I thought that was pretty interesting. It kind of mirrors the sort of movement of a diver. And of course, we will have the get-together diving boards in the pool area as well. Now, the inspiration for this was kind of weird, I guess I would say. I had this idea almost of a very almost upscale surfer inspired location, maybe something you would see in LA in a very chic lounge perhaps. So that was definitely the vibe I was going for. At this point, I am putting in a lot of landscaping, just using some base game with the palm trees, lots of foliage on the ground. You pretty much get my drift here. Now for the roof was very interesting. If you guys saw the earlier portion of the video, the roof shape was wild, you guys. I don't know what I was thinking. I was thinking I do want waves, I do want curves, but it just really wasn't coming together. So I was very happy with this end result, kind of just creating an ocean wave. Almost like waves that kind of curl over with a bit of white caps on them. So that was the inspiration there. There are also a lot of portions that have sort of a glass roof or sunroof, which I thought was really cool. And I will also make use out of the little roof area towards the back. Now, that area was so hard, I had to playtest it in game, and I'm probably going to have to playtest it once more. Because if you guys know, if you're trying to place objects within a roof structure, Sims can access them towards a certain point. But obviously, once that roof gets too low, they just won't interact with any of the objects because they can't access them. So I thought it was a really cool space to put a lounge, and we'll get to that in just a little bit. But I did want to touch base on that. Anyways, I am gabbing along, but we do have most of the poolside area done. I do use a lot of objects from both Spa Day and also Eco Lifestyle. So we do have the lounge chairs, we do have some sort of outdoor seating options as well. And I absolutely love this one object from Eco Lifestyle, and it's a tray with what I believe to be sparkling water. Now, we are in a nightclub or a bar, so who knows what's truly in them. But they could possibly be nectar, I'm not sure, but they just really fit this build, and I loved using that object. Anyways, you guys did just see this little lounge area in the sunroom, I guess I would call it, just carefully placing them in that triangular roof structure, and now also going in and adding some outdoor lights as well. I do have to shift a lot between the daytime and the nighttime, because The ambience is everything, you guys, especially if this is a more sort of nightclub-based venue. I'm sure this lot is going to be very active in the evening, so I did want to make the light very warm, very subtle, lots of little sprinkles of floor lamps, of wall lamps, so it's not overwhelmingly bright, but it definitely sets a certain mood. Going in now, I do change the exterior just a little bit. For some reason, I was very paranoid with repeating things. So if you guys saw one of my earlier mini speed builds, I did a converted schoolhouse and I had just gotten Eco Lifestyle and I was going for that really interesting white distressed wood that you see here, or at least earlier. But I saw I had already used it and I was like, you know what? I don't want to double dip. I do want to make this a little bit more earthy toned, if you will. So you do see a lot of kind of wood tones. You see a lot of kind of stone textures with white and gray. And of course, a lot of the green from the foliage as well. So those were kind of the natural elements I was going for. This is just a look at the outside bar area. And I will also create another bar inside as well. Now, I will be honest with you guys, the pools were definitely a lot smaller than what I imagined. Not even pools, we only have one pool on this lot because it is just such a tight space. But of course, because I'm playing off the modern dive bar aspect, I did want to have at least two diving boards. And of course, we do have some ladders for Sims who just want to swim around. Obviously, I think this would be some kind of safety hazard in real life, but because we are in The Sims, I did give myself a little bit of creative liberty there. Anyways, we are finally going on inside, and like I mentioned, there is another bar inside as well. It's pretty much this very interesting sort of symmetrical reflection of what is on the outdoor patio space. But what I do like about the inside space is that we do have a lot of seating areas. We do have a lot of dining tables, if you will, and I really love this option from the get-together pack. I do believe the sort of concrete and wood combination is pretty much identical to the bar itself, so it did feel like it was part of a set. I do use the Eco Lifestyle chairs and also the little potted plants as well. Now, I will say there are certain elements I use a lot in this build, probably more so than what I should have. You guys will see tons of these bamboo plants from the Spot A pack. And as a sort of architectural element, I do use the sort of vertical wooden slats also from Eco Lifestyle. And they're kind of a pain to place. They kind of float around a lot of times where I want them sort of sitting flat. They'll kind of scoochy scooch against the wall. And it's this very hard kind of tug and pull game of sitting in place correctly. I think you guys know what I mean. Anyways, unfortunately, this location only has one bathroom, but of course it is gender neutral, and because there is only one toilet and one sink, I figured I would make a small sitting area right outside of that, right next to the staircase going to the second floor. Now, there is another area towards the back, and this is kind of a lounge, if you will, so I really wasn't sure what to put here. But I do eventually include some different fun objects for your Sims. We do have the foosball table from the Get Together pack, and I will also get a game table as well. Now, to be honest with you guys, it kind of bothered me that in the Get Together pack, there is only one option for each of these items. So the style wasn't really a good fit, but I definitely wanted some kind of interesting activity here. So those are the objects I went with. I do use this very beautiful drop ceiling light from the Spot A pack. It kind of feels like water, maybe it's like rain or the kind of water that would come down from a wave crashing. Perhaps I'm reaching at straws, but I do think it fits the lot here fairly well. Now going to the second floor was another puzzle for me. Originally, I really had no clue what to do with it. But I completely forgot this was supposed to be a bar. So here we are, I'm creating a sort of performance area, if you will. So we do have a small stage. I do include a microphone and also a guitar as well. Now, just like I mentioned earlier, I do try to use these wood slats and they are so hard. You can see they're snapping. I actually had to delete a portion of the wall in order to put them in place, but I thought they made a nice little accent. And I'm just finishing off the performance area with a stool. So I figured usually if there is some sort of stand-up comedian, they could sit on the stool. I think it's a thing. I don't really know for sure, but I did include that detail. And of course, because this is some kind of stage area, I did make a little aisle as well. So we do have lots of seating in the rows themselves and also another couch on the right side. I'm just finishing off this area now with more wooden slats just to kind of finesse the entryway, if you will. And then just a little sitting area outside as well. Really wasn't sure what to put here. I wish I could have made a bigger bathroom. So that still bugs me, but I think it'll be fine. But anyways, going back to the stage, I did remember this object from the base game, and I thought it fit here perfectly. It gave a little bit of a sort of accent color, some sort of spotlight, if you will. And now we're just going outside and we're finishing the final balcony area. Now, originally, I did have some overhead lights. I think they were the base game lanterns, but again, we're going for ambiance. We're going for nice subtle light. So I get rid of those, and overall, this area is fairly straightforward. It's more of an extension of the lounge itself. I do use these sort of reupholstered couches and armchairs also from the Eco Lifestyle pack. It's definitely a favorite object of mine, and it's very bizarre, but it certainly fit the vibe. It gives me sort of that driftwood feel, and I thought it worked here perfectly. I do finish off this area with a few plants, and of course, I do love this little tray object, so it is here once more. And at this point, this build is fairly done, but I do make a few adjustments. I did have a little tiny dressing room on the second floor, but I just remember that I could also use the closet from Get Together, so hopefully performers can use that to change into a more flashy outfit. I also wanted to include an aquarium. We do have that from Spa Day, so I did use that, and it also further drove home the theme of diving, of ocean, of water. So I certainly want to put that item in there. I do also finesse this little sunroom area just a little bit. So again, more sparkling water. Here I go, you guys. And also more bamboo plants. To make this room feel a little bit more intentional, I do use these planter boxes that I do believe are from Spa Day. So I think it tied the room together fairly well, and I tried to make them sit flush against each other. I also go back to the sort of pool area, and I also put in just a few towels and, of course, some fans by the bar just to keep it nice and cool. Now, as a final spot, we did need some outdoor trash cans. So I tried to make this area as nice as I could. It's definitely more utilitarian, but I think this pretty much gets the job done. Just using this little insignia from the Spa Day pack. And I think that pretty much wraps up the build itself. The last feature I have are just these really cool wall speakers, because we definitely need some nice tunes at the club. Alright guys, and that is my take on the modern dive bar. Definitely was a really fun build for me, and I do hope you guys like the little twist I put on this. And I will also say that if you would prefer this lot to be a nightclub, it is fully compatible with both the bar and nightclub venue options. Hopefully this is something fun for your game, and if you are like me and enjoy The Sims 3, this is very much indicative of a poolside club. Just like always, this is still a no CC, no mod, limited pack build, and I will leave you guys now with the final lot specs along with the final cinematic shots of the build. With that said, this has been TownieSimBuilds, signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys,